Hello and welcome to Fast Effect Double Speed Magic the Gathering from ELD's Time Vault Games in Bellingham, Mass. This is the finals of the ELD Legacy Open as Arnold leads out with a basic island into Delver of Secrets, the ideal draw for a blue-red Delver deck. Rax, on the other hand, playing Maverick. We'll see what type of opener she has. Looks like a basic Plains into Mother of Runes, a card that can give blue-red Delver fits here. Arnold actually recognizing that and Force of Willing the one drop. During the upkeep, Brainstorm to make sure this Delver flips. It is only a matter of time before Maverick overwhelms blue-red Delver with just bigger, nastier threats. Arnold gonna need to compress this game state down and get Rax out of there before cards like Knight of the Reliquary and Scavenging Ooze can just tower over the board. They make these three power creatures look absolutely tiny, squish them like the bugs that they are. And now a Thalia. And this aggressive draw could be exactly what the doctor ordered. Unfortunately for Arnold, that second Delver not flipping, but three damage, able to get in there. Five turns left for Rax. Mother of Runes, this one may stick. And a Green Sun Zenith, X equals zero, so it's just going to get a Dryad Arbor. Thalia not playing super nice with Green Sun Zenith. Delver does flip this time, and now it's just a three-turn clock, possibly less. A fetch land no longer in the mix for Rax, as it'll put her at just two turns. Swords to Plowshares or similar effect going to need to come up pretty soon. And at this point, Arnold likely just digging for a Force of Will. Unless he has another land in his hand. I don't love leaving the Volcanic Island as the soul untapped. You're not going to be able to cast a Lightning Bolt or anything off of it. But he does actually have another land. And a Dreadhorde Arcanus joins the fray. Completely tapped out. Force of Will not an option, even if he has it. Now's the time for some removal. Three mana, Sylvan Library. Feels like it's going to be too little, too late. Send flashback. We've got a Brainstorm. This Dreadhorde Arcanus not going to be surviving in all likelihood. And it's actually got the Lightning Bolt anyways. That is the way to do it with Delver. Just have the burn for lethal each time, and it's going to go your way. So Arnold picking up that first game. Delver's putting Rax down to one, and then Bolt finishing the game. Hopping in here. Post-shuffling, Rax taking a look. Gives the thumbs up and leads out with Mother of Runes. And again, that gets Force of Willed by Arnold. Though last game, absolutely no burn ended up targeting any creatures. A second Mother of Runes prompts a Brainstorm. And Force of Willing again. In this fetch land. Feels like it's going to be very bad news. Taiga. Is going to push through this Mother of Runes with a Pyroblast. Arnold forces the Pyroblast, or forces the Mother of Runes. Unreal. Just a couple of cards left in hand. Wasteland taking out the white source. Just red and green on Rax's side of the board. A Taiga and a Grove of the Burn Willows. Debatable which of those is actually better in Legacy. And now a Punishing Fire takes out the young Pyromancer, and hence the reason for the lack of clarity around which duel is better. Grove of the Burn Willows, such a powerful engine, it's actually going to be able to get back this Punishing Fire and kill almost everything that Arnold could possibly top deck. Young Pyromancer, Delver of Secrets, Brazen Borrower. Is a very bad time. Dreadhorde Arcanist, really the lone exception, and even that will eventually be able to be taken out by this Punishing Fire. Just going to need 5 mana to cast Punishing Fire, return it, and cast it again. And Rax is on her way to exactly that. A Mother of Runes. The card was fought over viciously earlier. Now one resolves without comment. Lightning Bolt takes out the Mother. Dreadhorde Arcanist allows for the flashback. That takes out the Scrib Sprite. And now a Thalia along with a Noble Hierarch. We've got Brainstorm off of this Dreadhorde Arcanist. You have to pay the 1 mana. Wasteland takes out the Grove of the Burn Willows, stopping the recursion and knocking Rax back a mana. And Forked Bolt, what a blowout card, taking out Noble Hierarch and Thalia. Unreal. Forked Bolt doing all of the work here and just sitting in the graveyard, daring Rax to try and recommit some X1s to the board. Devastating. Another Dreadhorde Arcanist. Arnold going to need some cantrips here. Attacking for 2 at a time with no upside. Less than exciting. A Knight of the Reliquary, a huge, huge threat at this stage. And Arnold gonna Forked Bolt and a Braid. Is that enough? Oh, and gets the extra 1 point of damage in with a Shard Volley, I think it is. Another Knight of the Reliquary comes down. All sorts of resources thrown at that knight, leaving Arnold with very little to deal with this second one. Pyroblast takes out the Delver of Secrets. And Knight of the Reliquary is going to turn sideways. fetching to get the extra point of damage in. Thalia comes down, and Arnold has to decide. No, he's got no decision left. He is scooping it up. We are on to game number 3 of the finals of the ELD Legacy Open. This happened February 8th this year. Rax picking up game number 2. She'll be on the draw as Arnold. Came out to a great start game number 1. Faltered after triple force of willing a Mother of Runes. Seldom seen plays. And game number 3 underway here. Both players keeping their 7. Arnold with a ponder. Rax leads out with a windswept heath. Into Green Sun Zenith. That gets dazed. Delver of Secrets now for Arnold. Stopping that Green Sun Zenith. Does quite a bit to restrain the curve for a Maverick deck. Being able to cast 3 drops on turn 2 or a 1 drop plus a 2 drop on turn 2. So much better. Now a Green Sun Zenith for 1. Likely going to grab a Noble Hierarch. That'll add some additional mana. Do as well as mana fixing. You've got blue, white, and green mana. And of course, Exalted, a nice bonus there. Potentially shaving a turn off from attacking damage. And now Lightning Bolt is able to clear it. So this flipped Delver of Secrets has set a clock. Grove of the Burn Willows. With a Punishing Fire. Bad news for Delver. Birds of Paradise sticks. And despite trying to restrain Rax's mana base, Arnold finds himself at a mana deficit. Though he does have everything that his deck needs here. Dreadhorde Arcanist. And Shard Volley, I think it is. It's like an Amonkhet card. Does 1 damage, clearing the Birds of Paradise. Rax with the 4th land. Can set back by clearing out a Volcanic Island. If Arnold's not careful, he may find himself bereft of red mana. Wasteland hits this Grove of the Burn Willows. That's going to prompt Rax to return Punishing Fire to her hand. And Brainstorm being flashed back by this Dreadhorde Arcanist into another Dreadhorde. Arcanist, a very interesting card. People were resistant to play too many copies initially, partially because of how quickly you can run out of instants and sorceries as you churn through your graveyard. Dreadhorde's definitely not at their strongest when they're just beating for 1 a turn. But Blue-Red Delver ultimately makes the best use of the card, not only flashing back cards like Brainstorm, Ponder, and Preordain to generate card advantage, actual cards in hand, potential counter spells, additional threats, but also going into beast mode with cards like Lightning Bolt, where you're just doing tons of damage each turn. You top deck a Lightning Bolt and flash it back. That's 7 damage in that turn. So Dreadhorde Arcanist, very capable of closing the game out quickly with the right mix of cards, and we see another Lightning Bolt, which may be very tempting for Arnold. A Mother of Runes. And that does get Lightning Bolt, Dreadhorde. Got a flashback Ponder. And Lightning Bolt for days here. This is going to be potentially an unexpected burst of speed, as Arnold can have quite a few Lightning Bolts here to the face if needed. Got a Brainstorm in response to this Noble Hierarch. Arnold could get rid of cards off the top of his library. He's actually going to opt to keep them. I didn't even see him draw a card that turn. I might have missed it. I think that's what they're talking about right now. Pretty sure the judge will have Arnold drawing a card. And Arnold making some type of note, perhaps to let the judge know what the top two cards are. It'd be good to know that he did not actually draw a card, unless I missed it. Let me know in the comments if I missed it, but I didn't see him draw a card. I do these all in just one take, so I will not be going back until this video is published. Got a lot of videos to get to. We do a new one every single day on the channel. And there should be some resolution to this pretty quickly here. All right, so the card being drawn, and it's going to be passing the turn. No, a ponder. Ponder. Drawing a card off of Ponder and passing the turn. Thalia. And Thalia will not be long for this world, as there is a Lightning Bolt in the bin. It's actually going to catch a Bolt from the hand, however. Trying to keep the mana as efficient as possible. Dreadhorde sends. Ponder shows, it's a red card. I believe it's a Forked Bolt. And just a whole bunch of burn. Really preferable. Oh no, Sulfuric Vortex. And that is a very rude magic card. Each player going to be losing 2 life a turn. Players can't gain life. Force of Will protects this Dreadhorde Arcanist from a Pyroblast, from a Swords to Plowshares, but Pyroblast clears it out, and the clock is ticking now. Rax only has 4 turns to live, but Arnold doesn't have a threat on board. If Rax can land a beefy threat and start swinging, she may be able to outrace this, and of course, 2 damage happens to each player. So really, 12 damage, a Knight of the Reliquary might actually be enough. Wasteland takes out the duel. Taiga goes to the bin, leaving a forest and a plain. So land plus Knight of the Reliquary could actually turn the tide here. Pushing through for, you only need like 6 damage a turn. When you combine that with a Sulfuric Vortex, Mother of Runes, that is not known for for decreasing life totals. The window is closing here. Forked Bolt clears the Mom. In just three more turns, Null Rod. That is not going to do a whole lot here. Grove of the Burn Willows, not capable of letting Arnold gain life from here. Another Mother of Runes. The card that was in the center of so much action this match now is just going to have to watch as Rax takes lethal damage from the Sulfuric Vortex. A punishing fire to the face, and the hand is extended as Arnold takes down the ELD Legacy Open with Blue-Red Delver. Congratulations to both players on a match well played. That is all for this one, but don't worry, there is a lot more. You can check out our older videos, and we're always putting out new videos from ELD's Time Vault Games in Bellingham, Massachusetts. If you want to help the channel, of course, you can like, subscribe, share, tap that notification bell so you can know the next time our new videos come out. Thanks for watching.